you're listening to The Zero Hour. Rest your eyes. Exercise your imagination. Today, Glenn Hall Taylor's study of violence. Bonnie and Clyde are alive and living as Marilyn and Bill. Starring Lee Meriwether. In the Mutual Broadcasting System presentation of The Zero Hour.
Brought to you by the Ford Motor Company, also by Sinoff, Tablets and Spray, Beech Nut Chewing Tobacco, and International Harvester.
Speaks of her ability to compete with a man in what she terms a man's world. And it's true that when she makes up her mind to compete, man finds he has competition of Olympian dimensions. The young man in this story is certainly an evil person, but his woman, in every way, is at least his equal in their world of crime. Nevertheless, the justice of the peace in a small eastern town has no reason to suspect either of them as he performs his traditional, if perfunctory, marriage service.
And do you, Mary Sherman, take this man, William Baker, as your lawful wedded husband?
I do.
And do you, William Baker, take this woman, Mary Sherman, as your lawful wedded wife?
I do.
Then, by the powers vested in me, I do hereby pronounce you man and wife.
Is that all?
Yes, son, yes, that's all.
Gee, Mary, I love you so.
And my very best wishes to you both.
Golly, thanks. Thanks very much.
And now I'll exercise my privilege of kissing the bride.
Oh.
Thank you, my dear.
Oh.
Well, look at her. She's blushing.
I'm not.
Well, thank you again. And now we better get going along because we got to get into the city sometime tonight.
Well, good luck, and if you happen to pass this way again, please be sure to drop in.
Oh, thank you. We will. Could I have my coat, please, Bill?
Sure, honey. And you better put it on. It's damp out tonight, and I don't want you to catch cold.
Excuse me, young fella. You forgot my fee.
Oh, I was just going to talk to you about that. You see, sir, we don't have any money.
You what?
Well, in fact, we were planning on getting some from you.
What do you mean?
I kind of hate doing this, you being so nice and marrying us and all, but we're going to have to hold you up.
I got a gun on you, mister.
Now, yeah, you hand over your money, please.
Certainly not. I'm calling the police.
Oh, no, you don't. Okay, Bill. You go through his pockets. I'll search the desk. Then let's play it.
Morning, Chief. Man, that sheriff's station's jumping this morning.
What's going on, Barney?
Well, it seems a young couple went into the home of the Justice of the Peace in Kernville in the northern part of the county, got married, and instead of paying the JP, plugged him in the arm, stole all his dough. Happened last night. Next, they hold up a car on the main highway and drive off in it.
For their honeymoon?
Yeah. A few miles farther south, they stop at one of those all-night diners, fill up on steaks and french fries, tap the till, and wing the proprietor when he tries to stop them.
That's a good story. Get on that typewriter and knock it out. Any leads on the couple or where they're heading now?
Well, the sheriff's boys figure they may be in our fair city by now. Each hit they made was on the route south.
But tell me, how did they get as far as they did without being picked up?
Well, it took the Justice of the Peace a while to put a tourniquet on his arm before he could phone the police. The guy they stole the car from had a 5-mile walk before he could get to a phone. By the time he made his call, the happy newlyweds had already pulled the diner job.
Well, if you get right on that, you can make the next edition of the story.
Okay, Chet, I'll have it on the copy desk in half an hour.
I'm sorry, I got the bacon too well done. It's almost burned.
Oh, now, hey, don't apologize. That was a swell breakfast. I cleaned my plate, didn't I?
You just did it to be nice.
Hey, Hey, would you like to move out of here into a nice hotel?
So you won't have to eat my cooking?
Oh, come on, sweetie. Don't say that. That's not the idea. That was the best breakfast I've had in a long time.
Do you really mean that?
Of course I do, Mary.
Well, then, I'd rather stay here in the motel. With the little kitchenette here and that hot plate, I can fix all our meals here. It'll cost us a lot less.
Well, that's a point.
Oh, Bundle, how much money do we have?
Oh, about $150 or so.
That isn't much, Bill.
Yeah, I know.
We could get more when it runs out.
How?
Same way as we got the first loot last night.
You mean get married again?
What's wrong with that?
Nothing. Nothing at all.
Oh, Don, I could get married to you every day for the rest of my life.
Hello, Chet.
Yeah, Barney. You got something breaking on the newlywed story?
More of the same.
What does that mean?
Another ripoff, another shooting, another justice of the peace. That's the second night in a row.
You're putting me on.
Nope. It was reported about an hour ago.
How come it wasn't reported sooner?
Well, the justice's housekeeper didn't find him till about an hour after the shooting. They got him to the hospital, but he didn't regain consciousness till this morning. The description of the couple's the same as before.
Any leads?
The only one I know about, I already gave it to the deputy Thompson here, is the one I got on the phone a few minutes ago. I called the hospital and talked to that first justice of the peace they shot. He remembered that just before he passed out, he heard the broad say something about getting back to the happy hour.
Well, there must be at least 100 cocktail joints in this town to cut the prices of their drinks in the late afternoon and call it the happy hour.
Yeah, but my hunch is, and the boys are going to check it out, is in this case, it's the happy hour motel on the main highway at the north end of the city. It's that that joint the cops knocked over a few months back.
Anything else?
That's it for now.
Okay. If you don't phone in something more final before we go to press, I'll update your story of what you just gave me and file it.
Okay, Chief. Thanks.
Bill, baby, don't stand around watching me while I'm doing this.
I like to watch you.
Honey, it makes me nervous when you look over my shoulder like, hey, man, stop blowing down the back of my neck.
Okay, then. I'll kiss the back of your neck.
Bill, stop it, please. I want this cake to turn out good.
Well, okay. But when you get that cake in the oven, you just watch out, because I'm going to chase you until you catch me.
All ready for the oven. Oven's already preheated, and all I have to do now is set the timer. And it ought to be done by the time we...
Just a minute!
Yes?
Get your hands up. Stay where you are, miss.
Deputy Sheriff.
That's right. You'll have to excuse me greeting you with a gun, but I couldn't take any chances.
Well, what do you want?
First of all, I want to find out about that car parked in front of this motel room.
Oh... Is that all?
I also want to know if you're man and wife.
Why, Deputy? Just because we're registered as man and wife in a motel, do you suspect Hank Panky?
Matter of fact, I suspect armed robbery and assault with a deadly weapon.
Why come to us?
You both fit the description of a young couple who've gotten married more than once and each time robbed and wounded the justice of the peace.
This is terrible. I had no idea I'd be a funny motel like this.
Ryan's not going to get you off the hook, lady.
Look, Deputy, we ain't got nothing to...
Darling, no. I think it's better that we just tell the truth.
How are you catching on?
We really didn't mean to hurt anybody. Honest, officer. I know. What if we were to return the money we took? Would that help any?
Well, that's for a judge or jury to decide.
Well... I got it right here in my purse.
You don't seem to understand, miss. I'm not interested in anything at the moment but taking the two of you in, so just close your purse and come on along here.
Hey, Mary, that was mucho cool. Honey, he really thought you were going into your purse to give back the money.
I told you a long time ago that if you'd marry me, we'd make one heck of a team. Oh, that's awful.
What, shooting the fuzz?
No. It's just that now We're going to have to leave before the cake's done.
Chief, here's today's episode of our honeymooner's cliffhanger.
What have you come up with this time?
Read it.
You found Deputy Thompson?
Yeah. I followed in my car when he went out to the Happy Hour Motel.
Yeah?
I parked about 50 feet away on the shoulder of the highway and waited. When I heard the shot, I piled out and got over there fast.
Yeah?
Thompson was bleeding so badly, I ran to the manager's office and called for an ambulance and the police. Then I stuck around until they arrived.
Oh, I see by this. The manager described the couple the same as their previous victims had.
Right. After they took Thompson away, I went into the motel room with the sheriff's boys and a detective from homicide.
Holy mackerel, how cool can you get? Baking a cake while attempting homicide. You don't mention them finding anything else besides the cake.
I was asked not to, but for your confidential information, they've got one clue they're following up on.
What's that?
There were a lot of recipes that had been cut from magazines and newspapers. And there was a page of a newspaper from which a coupon had been clipped. They checked and found it had been for a free cookbook. The couple seemed to be sticking with the name of Baker, at least each time they got married. So the post office has been alerted to watch for a cookbook from the canning company addressed to either Mary or Mrs. William Baker.
That means this story goes on back burner for a few days. I'll file this one so that it'll make the Bulldog edition.
Bill, what do you say we go out for dinner tonight?
Out? Hey, you getting tired of your favorite pastime, cooking?
You know darn well it's my next favorite pastime. And no, I'm not getting tired of it. It's just that I thought we ought to be looking around for a way to make some more money.
Well, we already know a way. Getting married.
Well, as much as I love you, we mustn't do that anymore. That's how that deputy tracked us down the other day.
Yeah, but you got rid of him.
I know, honey. But there's more than one deputy sheriff in this county. And a few policemen in the city, too.
Yeah, but they sure don't know where we're living now.
Well, that's why I wanted us to get this apartment. There's 100 units in this building and a dozen other big ones like this in this part of town. We've really gone under.
Yeah. Well, if we're not going to get married again, what other plans do you have for us earning a living?
Well, none yet. But you know something?
What?
If we had wheels, we could cover more ground and case this town real good. Gee, I miss having a car.
Oh, honey, so do I. But that car got awful hot. That's why I rolled it off the cliff into the lake.
Why don't we steal another one? Let's get a nice, plain, used one that won't attention, especially at night when we'll be doing our cruising.
That's okay about me.
Then we'll pull some jobs, get some cash, get rid of the stone car, buy one of our own. Oh, Bill, wouldn't it be exciting to get married again and go off on another honeymoon?
Yes. We'd
have to go out of state for our next marriage. Wouldn't that be fun?
No two ways about it, honey. I married me a genius.
No, of course.
No two ways about cooking being your next favorite pastime, either.
You're absolutely right, honey. Honeymooning is my real favorite.
City desk, please. Chet?
Oh.
Barney. Just thought I'd report that Deputy Thompson's going to make it. And better have a rewrite man stand by. The post office just called with the baker's new address on the cookbook. The sheriff's men are going to row on it right now, and I'm following in my car. Right. So long.
Nice little car, Bill. Does it handle good?
Oh, very good, honey. The clutch is fine. So with the stick shift, we can get a fast takeoff wherever needed.
That thing will be lined up in just one evening. Mm-hmm. We could hit three within an hour and be out of town like a breeze. About midnight, we could take that drive in against the movie theater crowd. Go from there to that liquor store just blocks away. Go by side street to the south edge of town. Hit that big service station on the main highway. And then if we really step on it, in another half hour, we could be across the state line. Am I still a genius?
Darling, now the most exciting genius in the world. I wonder if we should park the car just a few blocks from your apartment building.
Oh, no, honey. The cops don't know where we live. We could park it in the basement garage where no one will be looking for it. If we leave our car on the street, if it's been reported, well, they might start combing the neighborhood.
Yeah, you're right. Hey, honey, I just happened to think.
What?
Those parking spaces in the garage, they have the numbers painted on the floor in front of them, don't they? Well, it might kick up a stink if we get in somebody else's parking space.
Gosh, I don't remember. I only looked in there once the day we first looked at the apartment. You wait here at the curb a minute. I'll get out and take a look.
Hold it right there, Mrs. Baker. You, Baker, keep both hands on the wheel. We got you covered on the driver's side, too. All right, give me that purse.
No, you can't take...
Let go of it!
Gun in it?
Yep, I got it, Lieutenant.
Okay, out of the car, Baker. Hands on the hood of the car.
Good hunting, man.
Who's this guy? I'm Barney Wittenberg with the Daily Clarion.
What do you want?
I want a story on you and Mrs. Baker.
Something you can make a lot of sensational headlines out of, I suppose.
Why, no, Mrs. Baker. I wouldn't think of such a thing. I want a story for our society section. The editor just loves weddings and honeymoons.
Well, I got one for your obituary editor. Drop dead, mister. Drop dead.
I'm Rod Serling. Close your eyes. Exercise your imagination. And join us again on our next presentation of The Zero Hour.
Bonnie and Clyde are alive and living as Mary and Bill was adapted for radio by Glenn Hall Taylor. Lee Meriwether was heard as Mary Baker. Featured in the cast were Herb Ellis, Jacques Denbo, Jim Bowles, and Herb Biker. Zero Hour, created by J.M. Colas. Directed by Don Hills, is produced in Hollywood for the Mutual Broadcasting System by Radio Productions Incorporated. Music is composed and conducted by Stanley D. Hoffman. Rochelle Sherman, associate producer. This has been a presentation of the Mutual Broadcasting System.